right, Lydia, tell me what brings you in today.
Well, I have an excessive sweating disorder, and I was hoping that we could find something to help me keep it under control or cure it. Well, I've had this ever since I can remember, and I've dealt with it my entire life. My mother's told me that I started sweating on the bottoms of my feet as a child. But as I've gotten older, it's definitely gotten a lot worse.
So it started with the feet, and then hands?
Yes, then my hands, and then I guess the armpits kind of happened in middle school. And I didn't know that I had an issue, but then people started pointing it out, so I was like, oh, I guess I am a little different.
And during that time, how did you deal with it, especially being in school? It's probably gotta be hard on you.
It was. I didn't really handle it. I just kind of cried about it.
She started wearing jackets all the time.
Yeah, I would try to hide it a lot. I didn't want people to know because I was tired of rude comments, hurtful comments. So I really tried to hide it. Growing up was very hard, and I was made fun of a lot. People would call me names and such, and I would go home crying. But then I shared a video deciding to own it about myself on TikTok, and it went viral, and I found out there was so many other people who had it the same as me.
Over the years, it's gotten a lot worse, and I think it's created anxiety, but the anxiety makes it worse. She's very anxious and overthinks everything about, you know, what she can do. I can't open doorknobs. She doesn't drive because, you know, her hands are slick.
Is it worse in the summer?
It is a lot worse in the summer. It's a lot worse when I'm hot, and especially worse when I'm nervous.
Everyone sweats normally to control their body temperature, but in patients with hyperhidrosis, they sweat all year round, sometimes just buckets and buckets of water. The good thing is there are lots of treatments, nothing is permanent, and the main goal is to literally stop sweat production. I was thinking for you guys, if you're up for it, there's what we call toxin injection. I'm sure you've probably seen it. People getting little shots in their hands and arms. That works really well. Now, you're like, what's the catch? It is a bunch of little tiny little needles, but we numb you. It is painful. We do things to help, but most people are willing to go through it because you want your life back, and it's worth it. I want to give her relief as soon as possible. One of the best ways to do that is to use toxin injection that would stop the sweat gland from being able to produce sweat. It does last about 3 to 6 months. It's probably gonna be amazing for you. Like, when have you gone 3 to 6 months without sweating
Never.
A whole lot?
I have an extreme fear of needles, so the thought of needles drives me absolutely insane and makes me very nervous. But I am so desperate at this point to help me live a better life that I'm willing to do just anything.
All right, Lydia, we're gonna get you into the treatment room. I'm gonna get you into a gown so we can mark out all the spots and come up with a treatment plan.
Okay.
And Carmen, you're gonna wait in the lobby. She'll be in good hands. All right. The biggest challenge with toxin injection for hyperhidrosis is the amount of pulse I'm gonna have to give Lydia. It's gonna be almost 200 pulses, and that's gonna be painful. So we apply a topical numbing cream, and we let it sit for about 45 minutes to make sure she's completely numb before I get started. So, Lydia, the next thing we're gonna do is something called the starch iodine test.
Okay.
And what it shows me is the areas that are more active, the areas that you sweat more, are gonna turn dark purple. You doing okay?
Yes.
Let that dry. So the iodine, which is what I just painted on, is gonna bind to the sweat glands. And then when I apply cornstarch, it's gonna take up that cornstarch and turn kind of dark purple.
Oh,
so it lets me know which areas I should concentrate my injections. And you can kind of see it here. Look at that. Can you see that purple?
Yes.
So most of your sweating, even though it's your whole armpit that I'm gonna inject, most of your sweating is right in the center right here.
Wow.
The purple areas, as I inject Lydia, those are the areas that I plan on depositing more toxin to make sure that I really shut those sweat glands off.
I'm not even gonna look at the needles.
No, don't look. My biggest concern is the amount of injections that I'm gonna have to perform in order to give her some relief. And also the amount of toxins that I can safely inject due to her size.
Gosh, my hands are even sweating.
You also want to hold your hands? No?
Let's just see.
Let's see. It's very tiny. That's what it feels like.
Okay. Oh, I just hate needles.
Don't think about it.
Okay.
Think about what your next TikTok video is going to be. As I'm injecting into Lydia's armpits, I want to space my injections at least 1 to 2 centimeters apart, and I have to deposit a certain amount into each injection that I'm doing for this to work safely. You're doing good.
Thank you.
I'm almost done with this one. I'm actually very impressed at how Lydia is doing with the armpit injections. For someone that's terrified of needles, even blood drugs, I think she's doing really, really well. You're doing really good.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
This armpit's done. We're gonna move on to the next one. You did really good.
I was very nervous that it was going to be a lot more painful than it was, and I was nervous that I was gonna chicken out after one armpit or something like that, but it was definitely a breeze afterwards once I got used to the feeling.
Oh, this one is going a lot smoother.
I finished both armpits, so now it's time to move on to my biggest challenge, which is gonna be her palms and her feet. I know how painful it is. It's gonna be a lot more painful than the armpits. So it's good if you kind of just kind of stay flat for me like
that.
So there's also gonna be a spray. It's a numbing spray, so I'm gonna spray right before I inject.
Okay.
We'll start back here. We're gonna make a little bit of a mess. If you wanna spray this, it's gonna feel a little cool. There you go. You good?
Yeah.
That's it. That's what it feels like.
Okay.
Lydia's sweaty, slippery hands have really held her back. She can't drive or even comb her hair. So to make sure we can tame all of the sweat glands in her palms, it's going to take about 50 injections in each hand. Which one's worse, this or your armpit?
Hands for sure.
Yeah. That's why I didn't do that first. Yeah, only work. I'm gonna give you a break after this one. Break. Shake it off. You can move your arms. You're not stuck. Shake off the nerves.
Okay.
It is very painful. You're not overreacting. I mean, I've had people like jump off the exam table. Like,
oh gosh.
So you're doing really good.
Thank you.
You're doing good. Lydia is a real trooper. I've already given her over 100 injections, and I know it's really painful. But if she hangs in there, I'm confident that it's going to improve her life. You ready for the feet?
I am ready for the feet.
Think about how dry you're gonna be.
No, it's definitely worse than the hands.
That's why I did it last.
Break.
Okay. We're almost done with this one.
Okay.
One more syringe and you are done.
Okay.
You want your fan? Lydia, guess what, my dear?
Oh my goodness.
You did it. Good job. You're all done. How do you feel?
I feel great. I feel accomplished.
That treatment went really well. Lydia did an awesome job. I'm very excited because I know what the next 3 to 6 months is going to be like for Lydia. She's going to have a whole different lifestyle ahead of her. How's that going to change? What are you going to do differently?
My life is going to be so different. Aww. I'll be able to do just normal things.
Yeah, do your hair, brush your teeth, cook for yourself, run your own errands. Aww. Everyone's gonna make me cry. I'm like, every time I cry. You didn't think there was anything that can be done, did you?
I'm so excited. Thank you. I just feel like she has helped me not only cope with this, but hopefully live freely.